The nadir of race relations refers to a time in the early 20th century when racism was at its peak. According to many historians, racism in the United States was worse in this time period than in any other period before or since. Africans lost many of the civil rights they had gained during Reconstruction. Anti-black violence, lynching, segregation, legal racial discrimination, and white supremacy were increased during this period. Senator Bill Tillman of South Carolina quoted, "We have done our level best to prevent blacks from voting. We have scratched our heads to find out how we could eliminate the last of them. We have stuffed our ballot boxes. We have shot them. We are not ashamed of it." The race riot of 1908 made it clear that there was an urgent need for an effective civil rights organization in the United States. This event was often cited as the catalyst for the formation of the NAACP. The NAACP was formed when Mary White Ovington, William English Walling, and Henry Moskowitz met in New York City in January of 1909. They asked for support from more than 60 prominent American families and set the meeting date for February 12, 1909. They wanted the date to be the anniversary of Abraham Lincoln's birthday, because he emancipated enslaved African Americans. Even though the meeting didn't take place till 3 months later, February 12, 1909 is often considered the founding date of the NAACP. The first meeting of the NAACP actually took place on May 30, 1909. It was called the Niagara Movement Conference, and it took place at the Henry Street Settlement House in New York City. An organization of more than 40 people emerged, calling itself the National Negro Committee. At its second meeting on May 30, 1910, members chose the name the Association for the Advancement of Colored People for the organization and elected its first officers. Jim Crow laws were state and local laws in the United States enacted between 1876 and 1965. They supposedly provided separate but equal treatment and status for African Americans. In reality, the accommodations and treatment of the white Americans were usually better than that of the African Americans. This caused many economic, educational, and social disadvantages. Jim Crow laws supported the segregation of public schools, public places, and public transportation. It even segregated restrooms and restaurants for blacks and whites. They also segregated the United States military. The number of lynchings rose to an all-time high during the Nadir. Lynchings are defined as extrajudicial punishments met by a mob. They are usually hangings. Nearly 5,000 Americans were lynched between 1860 and 1890. 3,437 were African American and 1,293 were white Americans. White Americans actively participated in the lynchings. Many others watched but did nothing to stop them. In 1922, an anti-lynching bill was passed, which protected people against lynching and punished those who participated in it. The case of Plessy v. Ferguson in 1896 was a huge contributor to the Nadir. It involved the constitutionality of a Louisiana law that required separate accommodations for white and colored passengers on railroads in the state. Homer Plessy, a citizen of Louisiana, had been arrested for refusing to sit in the car designated for blacks. After his conviction in the state courts, Plessy appealed to the U.S. Supreme Court, claiming that the stature was contrary to the 13th Amendment and the 14th Amendment. For a majority of seven, Justice Henry Brown delivered the opinion defending the Louisiana law. Interpreting the 14th Amendment, he declared, "The object of the amendment was undoubtedly to enforce the absolute equality of the two races before the law, but in the nature of things, it could not have been intended to abolish distinctions based upon color or to enforce social as distinguished from political equality or a commingling of the two races upon terms unsatisfactory to either." The court denied that the law stamped the Negro race with a badge of inferiority, suggesting that it was only the case if blacks chose to think of it that way. The Nadir had many traumatizing effects on black Americans, some of which are still a problem today. But I firmly believe that with the help of education and time, all races will become truly equal.